Melissa Sardelli here with your online nightly newscast. Here's a look at the stories getting the most clicks on WPRI.com for Monday, December 20th. A former Providence official who pleaded guilty to drug charges is sentenced to prison. Edward Buckles Malisi was sentenced to 46 months in prison this afternoon. He's expected to turn himself into start serving his sentence on January 11th. Malisi admitted back in July to charges he illegally sold prescription drugs. He was previously sentenced to 4 years in prison in 1984 for shaking down a snowplow operator for $64,000. And we first reported it as breaking news on Eyewitness News Live at 5. Cumberland police are investigating the suspicious death of a woman. The victim's body was discovered inside this Titus Street home by family members this afternoon. Neighbors tell us a family, including parents, three children, live inside the residence. No word on the victim's identity or how she died. And be sure to stay with WPRI.com for all the latest details on this developing story. And we're working more developing news tonight on a death investigation in Portsmouth. Police are now identifying the woman who was found dead inside a partially submerged car in Gull Cove on Friday. She's 56-year-old Catherine Cabral of Warren, a part-time instructor at URI. Within the last hour, the state medical examiner has determined the cause of death was drowning. And we've also learned the car was registered to Cabral's brother. Tonight, the circumstances surrounding her death remain under investigation. And grief counselors were on hand at Seekonk High School today following the death of a student in a hit-and-run crash. 18-year-old Jacob Mayle was struck late Friday night as he walked along the side of Route 195 in Seekonk. Mass State troopers have found the car they believe hit Mayle, but at last check, no arrests have been made. And for all of your up-to-the-minute online news and weather, stay with WPRI.com. Thanks for watching.